Well, live, we're back here on Football 360. It's live every Sunday from 9:30 to 10:30. It's kindly proud to be associated with DStv Super Sports, your world of champions, Fan Yogurt, and also Barclays. They are proud sponsors of the Premier League. Quickly, we're talking about the Black Stars. They've announced their squad for the upcoming qualifier against Comoros. I'm sure most of us are not too particular concerned about it because the opponent is Comoros. But the story is that Asamoah Gyan has been out of the team due to injury. Will return to the side for this two-legged tie with Andrea Ayew also making the squad. Former Ghana under 20 striker Ebenezer Sifo has been named in the squad for the World Cup second round qualifying match. So I'm sure apart from those notable entrants, or probably there's a new one called Phil Owusu-Aye, who is also joining the team. And the rest are pretty much your usual suspects. Roman, you do this every day.
Yeah.
Surprise.
Big omission is injured Christian Atu.
Injured Christian Atu?
Christian Atu, yeah.
For once?
Yeah, he's out.
That's only because he's injured. Yeah, because he doesn't play for club, but he plays for country.
Yeah. He does well for country.
So whenever. We can accept that.
Genuinely, there are players that are very, very good when it comes to national. Nicholas Benton, I was one.
Yeah.
He didn't play very well with Arsenal, but whenever he wore the Denmark jersey, he did very well. Yeah, you spoke about Gyan. Gyan has been injured for some time now, especially, you know, it's been since the beginning of this year when we went to Equatorial Guinea. Even before that game against Algeria, when he came to score that goal, he was injured in and out. He moved from Al Ain, went to Shanghai SIPG. But he's coming back. He looks fit now. He says it's okay to play. And it's big news whenever you have Gyan, not only because of the goals, Nuti, but because he's a skipper of the side. He's the leader. He's got a lot of influence in the team. There's another big news for us in the team is Jonathan Mensah. Remember, he was banned for 4 months at club level. He came to play his first league game last Friday, and I'm told he's on a flight as we are speaking on his way to Ghana here. And so a couple of the guys coming in. And the big news also is that we have 3 players in our local league in the team for the first time. This is the first time under Evan Grant we're having 3 players. And Samuel Tete, Wotuafa, Richard Ofori, the best goalkeeper, they just ended first Capital Plus, and then Fatau Dauda. So slowly but surely, we are grinding and we are getting Grant to at least understand that we need a local breed in the Black Stars.
I mean, just to take it from the local point, I mean, I'm sure for Fatau Dauda and the other chap who is the goalkeeper, I mean, will not be too, because
for me, there's only one local player.
So it's Samuel Tete.
Because I'm not going to count.
Is he a good choice?
I'm not going to count goalkeepers.
I mean, after a whole season, do you think he fits
well,
the
he's,
bill?
Well, he's gone through the ranks, hasn't he? He's played on the 20s and all that, you know. I wasn't too impressed with him, but still he's been consistent. And I think it's good that he's coming in at this time, because he's coming from a more solid base than the clubs that we have. I mean, Wafa is an institution that is much more stronger than the Kotoko and the Hearts and everything. They have a football philosophy. They know very well what they're about and what they're doing. So I think that's good for him to be included. I'd like him to get 45 minutes. To be honest with you, I'm not taking anything away from Comoros, but I think the local Black Stars could have played this match quite easily, to be honest with you. I don't think that, I mean, you know.
No disrespect.
No disrespect, you know, I mean, the probably part-time shoemaker, you know, baker. No, let's be honest with it. I mean, this is their first time coming out. They'll just shiver at the name Black Stars, won't they?
Yeah.
They'll shiver. They'll do their best. But, I mean, you know, a match like this, I mean, there's a lot on it, but if you look at the local contingent and you've identified, cause let's say Maxwell Kanedu identified that, look, you know, in terms of their psyche, it's not quite there yet, and they'll take several years or whatever. As a coach, you've got to be able to address that issue instead of just writing players off. How can we build their psyche? How can we build them up so that it'll take a less time for them to be filtered into the senior national team? This is a match that could help them.
So clearly, what Nana is in is that it's the kind of game we probably should have seen 5-6 local players.
Very easily.
Yes, but
very
easily. I like the question you posed, if he was the right person, and something just pricked my mind. I went through my mind scanning the Wafa team. I wanted to find out if Samuel Tete was even the best player they just ended first after flash remaining. It was no. Our best player of the season, this particular ended season, Kofi Owusu, was not in the team. I'm sure they'll point to the FIFA Under 20 World Cup. But even in that competition in New Zealand, he wasn't our best player.
So again, it tells you, you're asking, so somebody who's going to come back and ask you, okay, who managed that guy? No. Why are you laughing? Who manages the chap?
No, I don't know.
You don't know? Are you sure you don't know?
I don't know anything about it. You see, the issue for me is all about criteria. Because, you know, you get this. Swag will come up with their first 11. PLB will come up with their first 11. Galco will come up with their first 11. And you see that it doesn't even correspond. Because what's the criteria that we're using? I keep talking about criteria for selecting players. And I still can't see what it is. Apart from going out there to Europe, this boy's been born to Mr. Poku, who married so-and-so, and they've got a son who plays football, but he can't actually get into the senior national team there, so let's draft him and bring him here. That's the only criteria I see, and I think that we've got to go beyond this. It can't be just a cosmopolitan mix of people who play in Europe, and we bring them together, and then we say we've got a team. We've got to pay more attention to what we have here. Where there are faults, where there are issues, we are coaches. We must resolve those issues. If it's a psychological problem, we must build their psyche. We must build their confidence. We must work on them. Opportunities like this exist. I don't see why we can't have much more local players in this side. And Samuel Tete, for me, should play 45 minutes. He's worn the national jersey before at other levels. He should play 45 minutes at least. We shouldn't be stressing Jan. He still has injury woes. Let's not get it wrong. You go on there and you see that there's a problem still. His injuries are taking longer to be remedied, you know, and that goes with the terrain. Let's not force him on an issue. Comoros, come on. Let's not force Asamoah Gyan. He's a top goal scorer and everything like that. You want to bring him in a game where it's crucial, where you know you need that telling influence. Not here, where, you know, a Baker may come and disturb him, and then we've got Gyan injured again, blah, blah, blah. Yeah. There are local players there. Let's bring them in and use them.
You both have mentioned that there are probably a lot more need for quite a number of local players in there. Yeah. Which players are we talking about?
There are a couple of players that, look, Kennedy Asher from midfield scored 11 goals for Liberty Professionals. Very good. Lawrence Latte, the skipper of Ashgold, one of the best defenders of the local team, played with the under-20 side also for some time.
Captain
of the side. And I mean, a lot of them, even when you go through even the likes of Kumasi, Asante Kotoko, you pick one or two players that played very well in this particular season. But the question is that they'll tell you that the national team is not for only local-based players. And there's a criteria. The criteria is simple. Every Ghanaian doing very well. So when you're drafting in a player from the local scene, he should have the ability to fill in the void and do equally well.
Yeah, but if you're talking about ability to fill in the void, let's look at some of the players that have been invited.
Okay.
And you're asking yourself, okay, like the chap who's been invited, Phil Ofosuaye, he plays for what? Eintracht
in German Division 2.
You're kidding me.
German Division 2.
You're kidding me.
So and there's Godfred Saka.
You're kidding
Indiana
me.
Stars, who was in the team, PLB team of the season.
You're kidding me. The guy plays in Division 2. Yeah. What criteria? So you're asking me who went to watch him and thought he was the best? Avram didn't stay in Ghana to watch the champion.
Avram signed the contract with us last year, December. So next month will be a year.
A year?
He spent less than 30 days in Ghana.
Can you imagine? And he's still at the hotel. He's still at Alicia Hotel.
He came in last night. And he's going to be here. They're leaving on Wednesday night to play
tomorrow. It's sad. And probably just to take us our next topic before we move into the European football action, we're talking African best players. And because of this particular issue, I probably will start off with the other side. They say African Player of the Year based in Africa. Mm-hmm. And you've got Abdul Kadruf, Morocco. That's Maghreb Titouan. You've got Baghdad Bounedjah from Algeria, Etoile du Sahel. You've got Philippe Ovono from Orlando Pirates. Yeah. He's Equatorial Guinea. Mm-hmm. You've got Kemet Erasmus, South Africa, Orlando Pirates. Samata from TP Mazembe. You've got Mefta from USM Algiers. You've got El Taib Ibrahim from El Hilal. You've got Muteba from TP Mazembe. You've got Asali from TP Mazembe. You've got Fehat from USM Algiers. I mean, there's no sniff of a Ghanaian in there.
A bit surprised.
Why should you be surprised? Oh, come on, your clubs are not doing well enough.
Come on, you look where they're coming from. It's from North Africa and TP Mazembe.
And a bit of Orlando Pirates.
One of Orlando Pirates.
To pick it. Didio Vono from Equatorial Guinea. The favorite to pick it is Mbawana Samata from TP Mazembe. He's from Tanzania. He doesn't play in the Tanzanian league. He plays with TP Mazembe. He's solid. I saw him today in the CAF Champions League. And I'll be surprised if anyone picks it. I'm surprised there's no Ghanaian because of Solomon Asante.
In terms of the Ghanaians who play for TP Mazembe.
For TP.
We would have been excited if he's there, that's fine. But my point is that it just clearly tells you that now there's a bit of recognition for people who play on the African continent. And this is where we should be. This is where we should be finding some of our players.
But that is why I'm telling you that I am a bit surprised. Because if you look at that TP team that just won the CAF Champions League today, they started today's game with three Ghanaians, Nia Jaya, Frimpong, and Solomon. And Solomon is as important in that team as Samantha. In as much as Samantha gets the goals are premium.
Exactly.
It happens. That's why I'm surprised.
But they're a requirement.
Because
Ovono is in there and he's mistake prone. Apart from the Africa Cup of Nations where Equatorial Guinea did very well, even Orlando Pirates, they keep switching him.
But Roman, what I'm just asking is that shouldn't this be where we should be aspiring towards, especially the clubs that we have? Shouldn't we see a Kotoko and see Ahmed Toure in there, even though he's from Cote d'Ivoire, right?
Yeah.
He's from Cote d'Ivoire, right?
Yeah, but plays for Burkina.
But plays for Kotoko in Ghana. Shouldn't we see something like that over there?
No, if you're dreaming, yes. If you're dreaming, yes. You see, the institution isn't set. Things are not ready. So we can have it as a pipe dream. Yes, I'd love to see Kotoko there. Yes, I'd love to see Hearts. But you sit here and we all sit here and we know the problems or the challenges both those clubs are facing. We're not going to see them there.
But do you think that if, for example, we got Avram and Cole, get a few local players in here and they play so well, and within the continent recognize them? Because if I may ask, do we see a lot of players coming from the local, the local Blasters tournament, the local tournament they play on the continent?
Do we see the Chan? Yeah. Steven Adams benefited from the Chan competition going into the World Cup because he played very well in that competition. There's a problem. There's a growing trend in Africa. First team coaches coach the Chan team, like the Ivorian team that defeated them. Michel Duché is the first team coach of Ivory Coast. He was a coach of the Ivorians who came here. They lost 2-1. We went there, they beat us. In Nigeria, their head coach is the coach of their local team. Yeah. Do you know what does that? Imagine the power and energy that drives through a player who is going to play for a home-based Black Stars, but is coached by the first team coach. He knows that he does very well. There's a big opportunity.
But that's a very good point, Roman. That scenario existed with Milo. And I don't know why it changed. Because I heard George Afriye some days ago say, the executive committee is going to think about reverting back to the same scenario Roman is talking about.
Because at least if the guy is unable to go to our stands every weekend to watch games, to be able to scout local players, at least if he got a 22-member team who are playing in the Chan, it's a good opportunity for him to always say, okay, to be able to focus on 3-4 of them and say, they could be a core that always come through to the Black Stars.
Yeah, but it doesn't work like that. It's because he's got a free hand. Because, number one, we don't have a philosophy. We don't have a football philosophy. We don't have criteria when it comes to selecting the players. And at the end of the day, we've heard what Avram Grant's assistant said, the way he thought about our players anyway. Because he said he didn't think there was any quality or anything like that. And then Coach Maxwell Canedo comes and he says, well, he just had the Chan team. He doesn't think they've got the psyche. He doesn't think they're strong enough mentally. So both these coaches have written our local players off anyway. So they're hardly going to turn around and start calling them in. And my challenge to them is, where we see the problems, they must fix it. Because that's why you're a coach. You get a player, he's not shooting right. You help him to shoot appropriately. You sort out his technique. He's not heading the ball appropriately. Once again, it's about technique. If he lacks confidence or whatever, you help him to build his confidence so that he can play. These are the roles and the jobs that are associated with being a coach. So if you've seen that the psyche is weak, build it and make it strong. If you see that the quality isn't there in the league, but you know the potential is there, spend more time with them and develop that potential so that they become quality players. That's your job as a coach.
Anyway,
we'll see that.
Was the guy who played for us in the last Cannes earlier this year, who came through at the last, and the striker, what's his name?
He came through
from the championship. He's loaned from Crystal Palace to
Kwesi Appiah.
Kwesi Appiah. Where's he now?
Well, he's injured. He was supposed to be.
Oh, he's over.
He's injured. Okay. But when he's fit, he'll come back.
I'm only asking that it's just amazing the way they can easily draft these guys from nowhere, and they just come into the tournament, the Black Stars, whether they have all the attributes that make them fit or probably qualify to be in the Black Stars. We never tend to ask. Then, like we're just talking about a chap, Ofosuaye from second division in the German Bundesliga. I mean, if he was that good, he should be playing the Bundesliga. And then we don't think it's okay to be able to draft in somebody from the local clubs and give him an opportunity, just be able to build his confidence, get him to watch Asamoah and see Asamoah kicks the ball, heads the ball, build some level of experience playing around a bit of the top professionals. I thought that is what is important, but unfortunately, we never see that side of it for the local clubs. Quickly, we'll go for our last commercial break. When we do come back, the focus will be on European football action, Spanish La Liga, English Premiership, and German Bundesliga. We'll be back in a moment.